Hello everyone, in this video we will see the different basic configurations for 8086 microprocessor. There are two different modes for 8086 microprocessor. The first one is called as the minimum mode. It is nothing but the single processor configuration, whereas the maximum mode is the one in which there will be more than one processor in the system. So for the minimum mode, the pin MN bar MX should be connected to +5 volts, whereas for the maximum mode, the pin MN bar MX should be connected to ground. So if you take the minimum mode configuration, we see here the pin MN bar MX bar is connected to VCC, assuming it is a single processor configuration. So here we have the 8086 microprocessor as part of the system and the clock generator. So the clock generator provides the clock signal for the 8086 and also supplies the ready and reset signal for the 8086 to start processing. And the microprocessor is connected to the RAM, ROM, ROM and the peripherals. Okay, so the address and data lines have been connected to these peripherals, and between the microprocessor and the peripherals we have what are called as the latch and the transceivers. So we'll see what are the function of these latches and transceivers. These are placed here because the AD0 to AD15, these 16 lines are multiplexed, meaning these pins will act as data for some period of time and will act as address for some period of time. So the peripherals need to have the address and data line separately. So before getting into the details, we will see the functionalities. So if we take the case of memory. So for a memory, it is used for storing some data and to retrieving the data. So storing the data is called as the write operation and retrieving the data is called as a read operation from the memory. So it consists of many locations which are uniquely identified by means of the address bus, and the content of the memory is written or read back by means of the data bus. So the control operation, whether it is a read or write and other signals, they constitute the control bus. So the address bus is unidirectional. So the locations of the memory are always identified by the processor. So it is unidirectional. The direction is from the processor to the memory. Whereas if it is going to be a write operation, the data is given by the processor to the memory, and when it is a read operation, the data is given by the memory to the microprocessor. So the data bus is bidirectional, and we have the control bus which determine the type of operations to be performed. So next comes the 8282 latches. The latch, so what it has, input, output, and we have the other two signals. So OE is nothing but the output enable, which is a active low signal. So the output will be enabled whenever this signal is low. If it is going to be high, the output pins are tri-stator or in the high impedance state. So meaning if OE is low, this latch will function. And the next is the strobe signal. So this is an important signal. So what happens is, when the strobe signal is active, whatever the input, that will be given to the output, and after removing the strobe signal, the output remains the same even though the input is changed to a different value. So this output remains the same when the strobe was given at the input. So further changes in input will not be noticed in the output. So this will be used to hold the address line. of the multiplex address and data line. So this strobe line will be the ALE address latch enabled. So this latch will be enabled by ALE signal. The next thing, we have the transceivers. So 8286 octal bus transceivers. So you have two buses, one side and the other side. So both are bidirectional, and we have signals output enabled. So when this signal is active, we will have the transceiver working functionality. Then we have the transmit or the direction pin. Okay. So what happens is, when the direction transmit is equal to 1, this bus A access the input and bus B access the output. So the direction is, the data from bus A is communicated to the data to the bus B. Next, when t equal to 0, bus B access the input and bus A access the output. So here the direction of transmission is from bus B to bus A. So these are the functionality of the transceivers. Now getting back to the minimum mode configuration, we have the latch. So what happens is, these peripherals, they require address and data. So this pin will act as address for some point of time and data as at some point of time. So for any operation, first the address needs to be given and then the data. So initial, during the start of any transaction cycle, first the microprocessor will give away the address. So that address will be latched by means of this ALE signal, which is the address latch enabled. So that value address will be latched by these latches and it will be supplied to the peripherals or memory. Next, after the ALE has gone low, these pins will now act as the data. So that will be connected to the memory and the peripherals by means of these transceivers. So this transceiver direction is controlled by the data transmit or receive. So if it is going to be a write operation, the data will be transmitted. So the direction of operation will be from the microprocessor to the memory. If it is going to be a read operation, the direction is going to be receive, so that the data will be sent from the memory to the microprocessor. So that is the use of these address latches and the data transceivers. So here the latch may be 2 or 3, because if it is going to be octal 8 bits, the address is going to be 20 bits, so it will have maximum of 3 latches, whereas the data bits is going to be 16 bits long, so we will have 2 transceivers if they are going to be 8 bits. Next is the maximum mode configuration. In the maximum mode configuration, the MN bar MX bar is connected to ground, indicating it is a multiprocessor configuration, wherein 8086 is one of the processors in the system. So since it is going to be more than one processor, a bus controller IC, this 8288, is used in the maximum mode configuration. So this bus controller, it has got different signals interface with the microprocessor and also with the other processors. So first, these status signals from the 8086 are connected. So this status signal S2, S1, S0 bar, they indicate it's going to be 000, it is interrupt acknowledge, or read IO port, write IO port, halt, instruction fetch, read memory, write memory, or inactive passive memory. The inactive passive cycle. So based on this status signals, further action is taken up in the multiprocessor configuration. Whereas if we take the other signals, so clock is given, AEN stands for address enable. So this is used for enabling the address when the IO bus mode is active, when IO bus mode is low. CEN is for command enable, and this IOB is the IO bus mode. IO bus mode is used to determine whether it is a system bus mode or IO bus mode. This command signal generators signals are memory read command, memory write command, advanced memory write command, IO read command, IO write command, advanced IO write command, and interrupt acknowledge. You see these signals, IO advanced memory write command and advanced IO write command, are signals which are given a clock cycle in advance to let the IO devices to be prepared for the IO activity. Then the control signals, data transmit or receive, data enable, master cascade enable, or peripheral data enable used in the multi-processor configuration, and address latch enable. So these bus controllers will be used in multi-processor configuration for taking over the control of the bus, along with the signals like request, grant signals to be used for maximum mode. So the summary what we have seen is 8086 supports two configuration modes. One is called as a minimum mode, which is a single mode configuration, and another one is called as a maximum mode, which is the multiprocessor configuration. Thank you.